Keyhole, the show in which I go around celebrities' houses unearthing clues so our panel here in the studio can guess whose house I'm in. So without further ado, let's meet our panel. First up, it's Fern Cotton. It's not Fern Cotton. It's Antony Cotton! She's the fittest Bolton bird I know. She's a DJ on radio and sometimes she's on telly. It's Sara Cox! And it's Alan Carr's brother, it's Jimmy Carr! Anthony, yes! How do you think you're going to do tonight, guessing people's houses?
Well, it's one of those, isn't it? When I watch it at home, I always guess majority. I guess them right.
Yes. So
you know, all... you know they show you the picture at home.
No. No, but...
So you think...
No.
You think you're a genius,
do you? Because I play and close my eyes.
Yeah. You play and you close your eyes?
Close my eyes when they say... when they were about to show the picture.
Jimmy, if I went to your house, how would I know it was your house?
Well, you'd recognise it because you've been there. That is how you... well, we're pretending we're not friends in real life.
I'm just making petty conversation like they do at top of programmes like this. Sara, what's your house like?
Nice. It's busy. We're just doing up the garage.
You're doing up the garage?
Yeah.
What are you, Joseph Fritzer? What are you doing up the garage?
Who does up the garage?
What are you doing?
Garage is for... so when you do up other rooms and you go, that junk's got to go, where are we going to put it? Garage.
Well, funny enough, we've had to take all the junk out of the garage so we could do it up and we've put it in our lounge. So we've essentially made our lounge where we sit and stuff and watch telly. We've just got, like sort of garden chairs all piled up,
a
leaf blower.
A panel, everyone! We've met the panel. It's now time to go through our first keyhole. Look closely for the clues. Some of the clues are curveballs. Some of the curveballs aren't curveballs. The clues, some of the curveballs are not even curveballs. They're red herrings. I don't know the difference between red herrings and curveballs. I'm just talking. I'll stop talking and now I'll just say, let's go through the keyhole.
Hey, Brittany. Hey, Tan Quan. What's up, Shaniqua?
I love the LA lifestyle, me. All the designer shops, pond wee juice, dog accessories. But who would live in a Beverly Hills postcode such as this one? It's time to go through the LA keyhole. You cut?
Yeah.
Cool. I'm not drinking that. Looks like muck. Here, hold this dog, because I think it's from the shit zone with my man bag. Stinks. Here, take it off me. I'm not holding this. I don't want to hold it. Mmm, oranges. I don't even like them. So, first impressions. Lovely, well done homeowner. I'm enjoying the gothic feel, illustrated by the gothic chairs. I'm enjoying the ream of family photos. But what does it all mean? Let's have another segment. Wow. What a living room. I
could well imagine the homeowners sat in here arguing and swearing as to why they've got a picture of HRH the Queen, or why they've got so many music books wrapped in cling film when they're never going to read them. But the best thing of all is this. Check this.
Look at the way it slivers out of the ceiling.
You're gonna have to give me a second. It's beautiful.
I'm slightly aroused, I can't stand up.
Fern Cotton on a rainy day.
Okay, cool. Let's go elsewhere. So here I am in the kitchen and Bayek, it's a nice one. But what can I see? Well, down here is a picture of the homeowner's dogs next to a pair of lovely posh cocks. Down here is the British flag next to a pair of lovely big jugs. Now, my mum always used to say that the cupboard under the sink was the window to a person's soul. Yes, it's the part you've all been waiting for. What have we got in here? We've got dog treats, tick. Anti-back, tick. And latex examination gloves, tick. I think we've all learned something here, haven't we? The kitchen definitely has a mature feel about it. I'd probably put it in the over 25s category. I suppose since the kids have left, there's less loud mouths to feed.
Kid, that's pretty rude.
Eh? You know what? I'm sick of you judging me. Will you stop being so judgmental? Eh? You want a reality check, you do? Come back with it. Oh. I'll be in my dressing room. I'm in the bedroom and by it, this bed's comfy. No, I mean, seriously comfy. If I'm not mistaken, I think it's one of those memory foam mattresses which remembers the way you like to sleep, so you don't have to, which is pretty handy for a certain somebody who might be sleeping here. Yeah, it's very comfy, this. I think it's one of those memory foam mattress things which remembers the way... I think I've said that already. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to have a little kip whilst we go back to the studio, because I'm a bit jet-lagged. I've taken my underpants off as well, so I don't sweat too much. What the fudge is that? What an incredible erection. Okay, that's the first part of the VT. We'll be going back to me in a minute. But for you guys at home and our studio audience, but not our panel, this is whose house it is.
It's an amazing house, right?
I didn't like that.
Never
telly.
Never mind the house. What about the telly?
I didn't like that because imagine at my house there could be like a small dog there, a child, there'd be stuff, and suddenly it gets scooped up. Holding on. Dangerous.
It was definitely a woman. Was it a woman?
Definitely. How did you deduce it was a woman?
Because it had there was it's a British woman, I think. Even though it's LA.
Sara.
So, because she's obviously very proud of being a Brit, she's got a picture there of the Queen and she's got the little flag there, so she's definitely an expat, isn't she? We said that. Okay. There was was the bit where you lost your rag, and that's not like you, because you are known as being quite a peaceful person of showbiz. So I thought maybe that was a clue when you said, stop judging me.
So what are you thinking, Jimmy?
Well, it was also sort of stuff about a big family, I got the feeling.
So a rich British woman with a big family. OK, let's go back through the keyhole. I'm here in just one of the walk-in wardrobes, and I tell you what, it's like Bloomingdale's in here. There's lovely dresses, nice shoes, handbags. I tell you what, let's have a fashion montage. Drink that up. And there you have it, an interesting selection of clothing. You could say it was what's that word?
Androgynous.
What he said. Or was it just two completely different sets of clothing? And that could be a clue. I get out of this now because I can't breathe. Here I am in this calm and collected office, a shrine to what this power couple have achieved. Everywhere you look, there's clues. Such as this sword! Which looks like it could belong to a dark prince. These tiny skulls, which denote to deaf and other hellbound things. And this big mug. There's this strong female character keeping everything in check. And this collection of ornaments and music awards, made of various heavy metals, including not one, but three Granny Awards. Wow, they're heavier than you think they're gonna be.
It's Grammy.
I said Grammy, didn't I?
Say, you made me do that, didn't you? Because I was doing the thing and you interrupted me, correcting me all the time. Here's a quick recap at the closes. Let's have a look at the closes.
That's just cool.
The closes are an also grown-up LA pad occupied by a glamorous power couple with a taste for British stuff and skulls. So who would habitat in a house like this? Back to me in studio.
OK, let's go to Sara and see what she has deduced.
I just want to wash my eyes after seeing you in that flesh-coloured
thing. Didn't you keep it all for your bank later on when you're at home?
A rainy day.
Yeah.
A speciality day.
Am I a speciality?
Now then, they're very glamorous, and you said power couple, and with the sort of monarchy there, and with the skulls and the music stuff, are they sort of rock and roll royalty, this couple?
I thought the biggest clue was the heavy metal granny.
I think you know who it is, don't you?
I think she was born in Manchester, but not a lot of people know that. She was born in Manchester, she's northern originally, and I think it is Miss Sharon Osbourne.
That is correct! It's rock and roll royalty, Sharon Osbourne!
We're not going to go through the keyhole. Unfortunately, they can't be here, so we're going live via satellite to Sharon now in Los Angeles.
Ooh. Sharon, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Sharon, you look bang-tastic.
You wearing my Spanx.
Yeah, don't put them on, Sharon. You might get pregnant.
I think I won't be pregnant, but I think Ozzy is.
Sharon, that's a new home you're living in there. How long have you lived there now?
I've lived there nearly 3 years.
3 years.
But we're moving again. Ozzy doesn't like it.
He doesn't like it. I would live there just for the telly.
No, he says it's too gay.
Sharon, tell him I agree.
All right.
You look younger than when I last saw you. What's going on?
It's just living in LA and the sunshine.
Yeah, right, OK, sure, let's go with that.
I'm not telling you lot what I've had done, so shut up.
So, did Jack and Kelly live nearby? Do they come round often?
They do. They live really close. We're all really close to each other, so we see each other all the time.
And is that why you're moving?
We're moving because of people like you coming and poking around.
Sharon, can I ask, have you still got lots of gorgeous little doggies? How many dogs have you got the last time you counted them?
I've got 10 right now because a lot of my dogs have passed away.
A lot of them have passed away? You've got fucking 10 dogs? How many did you have before?
16.
16?
So that's like, that's one of the most beautiful houses I've ever seen on this show. I mean, it's an incredible home, yeah. But presumably 10 dogs, it absolutely reeks.
It doesn't.
Yes.
I promise you it doesn't.
It doesn't, it doesn't. They're very pampered. They've probably had more baths than you.
Well, I take them in the bath with me. We smell like each other.
Sharon, is that the house that you filmed the X Factor bits in?
Yes, it was. Yes.
Yes, yes. Have you spoken to Louis recently?
I speak to Louis every week.
Oh, that's lovely, because sometimes when they go into a home, people forget about them.
Sharon, is it true that Ozzy is now a vegetarian?
This week. It won't last, though.
You've been together for 30 years now. What do you think the secret is?
We've actually just celebrated our 34th wedding anniversary.
34th? Look up there!
I don't mean this disrespectfully, but Sharon has got fitter, hasn't she?
You definitely have.
Oh, shut up.
You are...
No, I discovered a good doctor.
Sharon, when will we see you back in the UK?
Oh, very soon. I hope. I miss everybody very much.
Well, Sharon, it's been lovely talking to you on a big telly screen, almost as big as the one that's under your bed. I'm now going to give you the through the keyhole key ring.
Oh, I'm ready.
Here it comes. I'm coming. After the break, we will be going to another keyhole. See you in a bit.
A basketball hoop. There's tennis. Oh, just get that pig out of the shop. He's following me, that pig. It hates me.
Keyhole, before the break, our panel correctly guessed that the house belonged to none other than Sharon Osbourne. What about that telly? OK, it's now time to go for our next keyhole. Have a look at this. I've come to Cotswolds, to this 19th century farmhouse, and already my eyes are treated to a kaleidoscope of clues. Observe this 4x4 jungle jeep for driving in jungle. This outdoor swimming pool, which surprisingly has no diving board. This hot air balloon, which is perfect for a trip around the world. This farmyard is teeming with animals, dogs, cats, chickens, there's even a pig, all pointing towards an animal-loving celebrity. I don't like that pig.
It's like giving me eyes of vengeance. And I told you, I've sort of stopped eating, like, bacon sandwiches and stuff. Well, I eat bacon, but I just don't eat bread. That's why I look so spent. I'm in the very roomy kitchen. There's this trolley here for taking your plates for a walk. In the corner, there's a piano, perhaps suggesting links to music. Interesting. What else can I spy? Over here, there's this well-stocked fridge, adorned with many humorous fridge magnets, suggesting this person has a good appetite and a good sense of humour. Here I am in the outside toilet, which is what they use...
Hello? Yeah, no, I'm on set. Yeah, I'll call you back. Ciao.
Why don't you just turn your phone off, yeah, whilst we're filming? I'll do it again. Here I am... I've forgotten lines now. What's the script? I'm just having a splash in the bath, taking in this rather stylish bathroom. Regard the giant fish by a fireplace. Could this be an obscure but treasured item from the homeowner's career? And don't be fooled by the Britannia box. This is only sort of a clue. Okay, let's go somewhere else. Elsewhere. I'm here in bedroom and the first thing I'm noticing is the very loud decor. It's very loud. A little bit like the homeowner themselves. There's also further connection to music. There's pictures of David Bowie and a Clash album signed by The Clash. Clearly they fancy themselves as a bit of a DJ, hence on pillar. Over here, the homeowner really has brought the outdoors indoors with the complete lack of walls. There's a very sinister pagan vibe in here with the wicker man in the corner for sacrificing sinners and sweet virgins. Oh. And over here is one of many sporting facilities which I will now demonstrate in an exciting sporting montage. There's cricket wickets. Ah! An indoor football pitch. An outdoor football pitch. A basketball hoop. There's tennis. Oh, just get that pig out of shop. He's following me, that pig. It hates me. And this. Now this, I excel at. Let's tool up. So clearly, the homeowner not only has kids, but is a big kid themselves. It's got to be a wind-up, yeah? Anyway, back to me in the studio. Oh, bell works as well. Thought I look nice at bath. I look nice in bath, don't I?
You look like a sort of slightly collapsed meringue. You know, with all that foam still clinging to you like an old pavlova, but a nice one.
Thanks. Anyway, that's the first part of the VT. We'll be going back to me in a few minutes. But for you at home and our studio audience, but not our panel here, this is whose house it is. Don't turn around. Antony, we're coming to you first.
Okay. Well, I'm a bit confused. I think it's a man.
Why did you think it was a man?
Because there were lots of boysy, outdoorsy, sporty kind of things. Is it something that's to do with sport? No.
Over to you. Sara.
Well, that fridge was very full with lots of beer in there and lovely food and lots of humorous magnets on the fridge. The fridge seemed quite a focal point, so I think it might be somebody who's a bit fat.
I don't know. Have you seen the show before? Because they're going to come out of there. I mean, they'll be here in a minute, yeah?
Oh, no, I didn't.
Yeah, so I think definitely the person is a fatty boom boom. I think probably a fatty boom batty. I think the person is definitely a chunky monkey wobble slop. I mean, don't say.
Well, do it again, let's do it again.
No,
do it again,
and then we're not doing it again. You've no, said it now.
Sorry.
We're not doing it again.
No.
I think the fridge. I think the fridge is a focal point. That is bad. Oh, I think the fridge is a real focal point for them.
You're in trouble. You all clapped. Everyone who clapped is in big trouble when this person comes there.
So let's sum it up. There's a man who's carrying a bit of timber and not into sport. OK, let's go back through the keyhole. Welcome back. I'm now in one of the outer buildings. That's correct, they have an outer building, which they've transformed into their very own pub. So clearly this person likes a jolly old drink or two. Cheers, thanks. Okay, let's settle in and peruse some clues. Note the memorabilia on the wall that we've had to blur out, including this picture of a traffic warden. Why would anyone want a picture of a traffic warden? And there's an indication of a love of big furry animals with these grizzly bear plinth things here. Oh, and the 6'10" polar bear saving behind bar. Recognise. Okay, let's go somewhere else. I'm in office, which is decked out like a Bond villain's secret lair. Check out this map for plotting world domination, or perhaps maybe a booze cruise. There's this chubby Buddha here, which is standard, obviously, and chubby. There's also this phone, which I'm surprised isn't much bigger and more portable. Oh. Hello? I'm in office. No, it's rubbish, just full of office stuff. Ciao. Bloody prank phone callers. Over here, around the telly, there's lots of memorabilia that we've had to blur that probably triggers off lots of happy memories for the homeowner. This item particular is probably very valuable, and the homeowner would kill me if someone came in and kicked the shit out of it. But don't worry, it's in very safe hands. Whilst these decostumed animals kick the shit out of each other, let's have a quick recap and have a look at the clues. It's time to teach these guys some manners. A jolly nice domicile which showcases the homeowner's zany sense of humour, love of music, and a penchant for splashing about in pool. Fellas, you gonna let us out of here? Okay, so who would appetite in a house like this? Back to me in studio. Let us out of here now because this pig is giving me the funny eye. It's giving me dead eye. Look at its snout, it wants to spit on me. It's got snouty face.
Cotton shots! How could you have no idea?
I think I'm focusing on the wrong thing.
Anthony, you got any clues?
Was the Chelsea pensioner anything to do with anything?
Well, he was walking over the road really slowly?
Yes, yeah. The Chelsea pensioner.
Yeah. The massive phone? It was a massive phone.
So Sarah.
So all these bears... Does he do something with bears? Does he ride bears?
Shit, you all up. No, he doesn't ride.
Who's on telly that rides bears?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
I think the big clue there was the term domicile, which you would never normally use.
Anthony, you got any clues?
And his initials were on the on the pillows.
Yes.
So, who was it then?
Dom Johnny.
That's correct. King of the Prankers, professional funny man Dom Jolly. We'll be talking to him after the break and going through one final keyhole. See you in a bit. You probably didn't know this about me, but this is actually how I walk. It looks sad, but it's pure sassy swagger. Keyhole with me, Keith Lemon. Before the break, our panel correctly guessed that the homeowner was none other than King of Pranks. Yes, professional funny man, Dom Jolly, please confront Keyhole.
Can I just say that I apologise for suggesting you may be rotund, and in some cultures, your shape is celebrated.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
If in Fiji, it's a sign of being a good husband.
It's a lovely place.
What is?
Your house.
Oh, yeah, it is. Yeah.
How long have you lived there?
About a week before you arrived. I rented it for this show.
Well, it looks lived in. Well done for making it look realistic.
I live in Tokyo.
Really?
Yeah.
He's actually a Japanese schoolgirl.
Yeah, I'm actually a sumo.
Now, I remember reading a thing about you. Did you go to school with one of the Bin Ladens?
How many Bin Ladens is that? Or just one? Him who lived in a cave?
Yeah, it's true. I did go to school with Osama Bin Laden.
Did you know him?
No, I didn't. He was 16 and I was 6. And when I went back to a documentary in the school in Lebanon where I grew up, I found out, I thought I was the most famous person from that school. And I was really annoyed to be told by the headmistress that actually I wasn't at all. So I was like, well, come on, who came here? And she name-dropped Osama bin Laden, and I had to admit defeat that he won on that.
God, the more I hear about this guy, the less I like him.
You have got a hot air balloon.
I do have a hot air balloon, yeah.
Where do you get one from?
I bought it off a 70-year-old woman who claimed that she'd had a heart attack, and so she'd sell it to me cheap. And it was only when I found out it was called Patches that I thought, OK, that might not be the perfect one. But no, I really like hot air ballooning.
What's the longest you can fly in a hot air balloon?
Well, if you're in a hurricane, pretty long time.
There's a lot of memorabilia in your house from Trigger Happy. It was 15 years ago.
It was.
15
crazy.
Years ago, Trigger Happy.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
It is crazy.
For young people that didn't see Trigger Happy, how would you describe it?
Sort of a rip-off Candid Camera with cool music.
It's a bit edgier than Candid Camera.
It had some squirrel-on-squirrel action, yeah.
Yeah.
Love Tricky Happy. The Tricky Happy was very funny, but the soundtrack as well was incredible.
Yeah.
Do you still get people shouting catchphrases at you in the street?
Well, I haven't really got a catchphrase, have I?
Hello, I'm in the library!
The catchphrase is hello, which is like the world's worst catchphrase.
Chow?
Yeah. Well, chow wasn't even mine. Hello is my catchphrase.
Well, no, that's Lionel Richie's.
Actually, you're right. But I do. I get people chatting every day, hello. And I still don't have a good answer. It's just like, all right. I mean, what are you supposed to say?
What is the most dangerous thing that happened to you whilst doing Trigger Happy?
Yeah, no, I got arrested in New York on the Empire State Building dressed as a spy. I'd already had to get the big mobile into America through, like, American security, and that was a bit odd. Like, they're going, what is it? I go, it's a big cell phone. And they go, can you turn it on? And I go, no. So that was a bit of an issue, and then we got it through, and then we went up the Empire State Building, and we were doing a spy passing something to a spy, and we got arrested on the Empire State Building, and they have a little prison at the top of the Empire State Building. It's absolutely true. So we were arrested in there, but we broke out. It was such a rubbish prison. It was like a cupboard. And so when the guard went to call the police, we kicked the door open and we escaped from the Empire State Building. That was quite exciting.
Well, before I give you the through the keyhole keyring, I have got a gift for you.
OK.
It's a phone case for your phone.
Do you know what? That's actually brilliant. That's brilliant. Do you know what? I genuinely don't have one of those.
Yeah, yes, yeah.
That's brilliant. And you can just stick it on there like that. That's great.
And of course, like everyone, you get the through the keyhole keyring.
Yeah. Did I do that?
Yeah, yeah, that's right. Stand up.
Oh, yeah.
Enjoy it then, camera one.
Bon Jovi, everyone! I tell you what, I've always wondered who's underneath these things, though. Let's have a look underneath.
You know what's good is you spent the same amount of money.
Go on, piss off with it and take your hat with you, go on.
Come jolly, everyone!
Thank you very much.
Cheers, thank you.
Well done for correctly guessing it was Dom Jolly. Let's see if you can do just as well as we go for our final keyhole. You probably didn't know this about me, but this is actually how I walk. It looks sad, but it ain't. It's pure sassy swagger.
Lemon, you wanker!
Off! Thanks. See? The people of South London can't get enough of it. OK, let's go through the keyhole. Hold on, just drop something. Let's be in here in the lounge, or indeed, if you are American, the living room. There's a very young but old feeling to it. The young demonstrated by the blinktastic doorknobs, the very brightly coloured artwork, and the sparkly, twinkly lights curled up on fireplace. The old demonstrated by the glove-style beer chest and the dead shrubbery on mantelpiece. Interesting, but perhaps not as interesting as the dining room. Let's go there now.
You just move. Sorry. Back a bit, yeah.
Here I am in the dining room, a great place for dining with maybe five of your friends who might sit like this. Or like this. Or like this. But what could that mean? There's also this gym equipment here, which is confusing as it's meant to be a dining room. Perhaps the homeowner had a blonde moment and forgot. There's also these large black and white photos of the homeowner, but we've had to blur it out, otherwise this VT will be defuncted. OK, let's go somewhere else. Can you see my mouth blurred now as well? Word to your mum, here I am in the garden, or if you're American, the backyard, but what can I see? Well, behind me, there's a dustbin, or if you're American, a trash can. Down here, there's a football, or if you're American, a soccer ball. And there's also a barbecue, or if you're American, a barbecue. And there's also what looks to be an American tourist in the garden. Are you lost? Are you all right?
Do you know where Leicester Square is?
No, I don't, sorry. What I'm trying to say is this garden is great, or if you're American, what do you say in America for great?
Awesome.
Awesome. OK, let's go somewhere else. That American man was a clue, wasn't it? Is he American? Welcome to the kitchen, and what a welcoming kitchen it is. I say that, why? Because
There's a message on the notice board that reads, "Hi, Keith," and I think that's very welcoming. Over here is lots of fruit and veg, so obviously this person likes to cook and treats their body like a temple. There's also an old radio, which is perfect for listening to some of your favourite pop songs. Don't you think? Don't you? Hey, here's a good clue. There's 19 gold and platinum discs in recognition of a good clue. OK, cut to me in the nursery. I've come up here to show you that this person has a little baby person in their life, which could be a clue, although it's not as good a clue as the golden and platinum discs is on stairs. And on that note, it's time to go back to you guys in the studio. Okie-dokie, I'm not going to reveal whose house it is yet. We'll do that after the break, but for now, I just want one word from your observations. Antony, one word.
Music.
Sarah.
Oh, feminine.
Feminine. Jimmy.
Hygiene.
Hygiene?
No, she just said feminine. I thought we were doing word association.
Music, feminine, hygiene. Let's see if those words make any sense when we reveal who it is after the break. But for you at home, here's a few extra closes. Fruit Keyhole. Before the break, we went round to this house. Our panel gave me three words from their observations, which were music, feminine, hygiene. Let's see if those words make any sense and see if they're relevant.
What has happened to this show?
Whose house it is to you at home and our studio audience, but not our panel. Don't turn round. This is our says. OK, let's see if you can work out who it is as we go back through the keyhole. Hello and welcome back. I'm now in the master bedroom, or should I say the mistress's bedroom. By that, I don't mean lady of the night. I mean we are in a lass's bedroom. How do I know this? Well, just check out the abundance of shoes, trainers, slippers, sandals, and these weapons. Ooh, they could cause some damage, couldn't they? Over in the corner here, there's a makeup mirror surrounded by lighting fixtures, which looks like it's been stolen from a video/photo shoot. Ooh, it's one of those memory foam mattresses. You know, I thought there'd be more levers and corsets and bumless chaps in here. Bit disappointed, actually. But perhaps they've left all that behind them. OK, what's next?
You've got to do the final clue.
What's the final clue?
You've got to dance.
I've got to dance?
Yeah.
You're kidding, aren't you?
No, just a small one.
Oh, yeah, dancing. OK, press play on Boombox.
I'm sexy and I know it. I'm sexy and I know it.
Yeah. When I'm at the mall, security just can't buy them all. And when I'm at the beach, I'm in a speedo trying to tan my cheeks. This is how I ride, my lady is the top of God. We head to the bar, baby, don't be nervous. No shoes, no shirt, and I still get service. Watch!
I'm sexy and I know.
I tell you, I hate dancing. Just because I'm not very good at it. Oh, cut the track, cut the track. Right, let's have a quick recap.
and have a look at the closes. Don't make me dance anymore.
Don't you think this super cool cat has a perfectly judged London townhouse? It's poppy, sassy and fit, just like the homeowner.
So who would habit it in a house like this? Back to me in studio.
Because of health and safety reasons, they wouldn't let me do the backflip, but I can do the backflips.
I wondered why you made me put on that wig and that jacket, but it makes sense now.
Antony, let's come to you.
Obviously in the music industry. She's obviously
why?
Because
the gold discs.
The gold discs on the walls. And it's obviously an American girl.
Sarah.
Sassy, there's a lot of dancing going on, which makes me think this person is known for dancing.
I think someone actually said, you've got to dance.
Got to dance, yeah.
So you've got a dancing American woman. Do you think you know who it is, or do you need to go through my keyhole?
Don't you want us to talk a bit more about it?
I think the door was the clue. So it's a pussycat doll, right?
Is it Kimberly Wyatt?
That is correct! TV judge and former pussycat doll, Kimberly Wyatt, please come from the keyhole!
Were you a dancer first and then a singer? How did you?
Yes, dancer first. Well, gymnast first, then dancer, then singer.
Gymnast.
Jimmy! I'll ask the fucking question.
Just, I've always wanted to have sex with a gymnast. It's not anything rude. It's just
I'll ask the questions!
No, the reason is, I just think afterwards they do an amazing dismount.
Kimberly.
Yes.
You look very nice.
Why, thank you.
Were you a singer first or a dancer first?
I was a gymnast first, then dancer, then singer.
Oh, a gymnast?
Yes.
What's one of those then?
Someone that likes to flip and do handstands and things.
Yeah, can you do a cartwheel?
I can do a cartwheel.
Jimmy, can you do a cartwheel?
Oh, yeah.
Show us.
Please!
Literally, show us a cartwheel. Don't say you can do a cartwheel and not do one.
I can't do a cartwheel.
Cartwheel, come on. Come on. I'll do one.
Fine, I'll try and do a cartwheel. I can't do a cartwheel. How do you even...
I don't know. Are you going to do one? I'll do one.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Saturday night on ITV, we're doing cartwheels. I don't even know if I can do one.
Pretty sure you can't. Look
Five,
at you.
Six, seven, eight, cartwheel!
Yeah!
I can't do a cartwheel. Just a little one.
How long ago is it since you split up from the Pussycat Dolls?
It has been almost 6 years.
6 years?
It's 10 years this year since Don'tcha.
No.
Isn't that nuts?
Wow.
Awesome.
You've got a lovely house.
Thank you.
And you've made a baby and got married.
Yes.
Congratulations.
We're back.
There is lots of pictures of your wedding day around your house.
Yeah.
That's a nice one.
He had a picture of me put on his waistcoat and surprised me right before he did his
How romantic is that? That's really nice. I loved that picture. Well, I'll tell you what, I've got you a little gift.
Did you?
If you loved that so much.
Uh-oh.
Got your little waistcoat, yeah?
It's got that on that. I had something else made while I had that done as well. Check this.
Oh,
now, you,
no.
I have just done a cartwheel, so I might be a bit sweaty.
on the first dance at your wedding, was your husband nervous because you're a very good dancer?
Yes.
And he was nervous?
Massively nervous. He didn't want to do it.
Did you show him up?
No, we kept it simple.
You kept it simple because he's a bit simple, yeah.
I tell you what, Kimberly, you're very well known for this move.
Yes,
yeah. Can I just say, because you've got baby Willow, who's beautiful, who I saw at the comic relief scene, and she's gorgeous. Was that position helpful for the birthing?
I would like to be.
It was bloody helpful for the conception.
Can you still do that?
I can, yeah.
Do you do it now?
Probably not in these pants.
Will they rip?
Yeah.
Let's have a go at doing that.
Yeah, there's no way you could.
You want some help?
Go and get it all. Go on. Do you ever go into a shop and just say, can I have a look at that over there?
But I did. There was one time when it really came in handy. It was when I first moved to Los Angeles, and I was a horrible car that was definitely bound to break down, and it did. And I knew I had to put oil in it, but the stick that held up the hood had broken. So there I was, with my foot up in the air, holding the hood with the funnel and the oil, putting it in.
Imagine driving past that!
And I heard two guys laughing behind me, and I turned around and I was like, do you want to help me? They're like...
Yes! 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 Kimberly, you've got a lovely house, and like everyone else, you do receive the Through the Keyhole keyring.
Very excited about that.
Enjoy it, that's number one.
Thanks so much.
Well, that's the end of... Where are you going? Sit there, lass. That's the end of the show, but what a journey it's been. We went to the Cotswolds, we went to Beverly Hills, and we went to London. I'd like to say thanks to our panel. To the stars that kindly let us into their homes and their arts. I will Keith Lemon. If I don't see you for a week, I'll see you through Keyhole.